So here, Rossi, Eric, and then Sage. It's all in order. You're going first, and then it's the same thing.
Yeah, I just wanted to.
There you go. Well, the moment has arrived. Good evening, everyone, and welcome. Before we begin our graduation ceremony tonight, I would like to give you a few reminders so that this evening can be successful and fitting in recognizing our graduating eighth graders. First of all, please take a moment to silence your cell phones. And this is a nice one. I would like to remind you that while during liturgies we don't allow flash photography, because this evening's event is outside of Eucharistic liturgy, flash photos will be allowed. We have given out many awards this morning at the breakfast and have kept part of them for this evening's ceremony. A full list of awardees will be sent home with students' report cards and can be added to the programs and other mementos that you may want to keep from today's events. The awards and certificates that will be presented tonight have come from those students who used our application process. Please refrain from any loud hooting or hollering during the ceremony. Clapping is appropriate. Finally, there is a reception in the hall after this ceremony to which all of you are cordially invited. Now I think we are ready to begin. Students, you may take your seats, please. Before I welcome up Rossi Pham, who will give the welcome address, I just want to convey a message from Father Ed, the pastor of St. Stephen's. He sends his best and is sorry he can't be here in person, but wanted to let you know that he's thinking about you and wishes you well.
And so now let me call up Rossi Pham, please.
Good evening, parents, teachers, and graduates. My name is Rossi Pham, and I've attended St. Anthony Catholic School for 9 years. Before I begin my speech, I would like to give my thanks. To the parents, we, the class of 2022, thank you for sending us to this great school. Your utmost support in our academics, faith, and athletics has helped us more than you could ever imagine. Your loud cheers at our games inspired us and made it the most fun any of us have ever had. And the many hours you sacrificed driving us to and from games and practices is something we're all truly thankful for. I welcome you all here to celebrate this one last reunion at St. Anthony School. We finally made it here, the best looking class in the history of St. Anthony. Not really. As I stayed up till midnight thinking, how do I start writing this speech? I wondered and wondered, till I finally realized something. Using Mr. Johnson's favorite saying, the saying drilled into the heads of all of junior high, I began to work smarter, not harder. Thus, I turned to my best friends, Google and YouTube. In doing this, I realized that this is the one time I'm going to be writing something and presenting it without being graded. So, Mr. Ramos, I'm sorry, but for one time, I don't have to use my critical thinking sheet or wonder if my intro conclusion are good enough. Also, I'm sorry if this speech is a little boring or too long. It's not my fault everyone wanted to be mentioned, Paige and Lauren. Because of COVID, our junior high years were far from normal. Online school was a challenge for a lot of us, and we missed out on a whole year of bonding and a whole year of CYO sports, while also battling the challenge of trying not to use our phones during our Google Meets. Despite that, we persevered. We used Mr. Ramos's favorite equation, E plus R equals O, or event plus response equals outcome, bringing us to where we are now. I think everyone knows that Mr. Ramos is big on the whole preparing for high school aspect of eighth grade, but a lot of us take for granted what he does for us. Sure, his class is pretty difficult. Skits on short notices, essays every day, posters, and group projects, but that's exactly why he gives us this work. It's to prepare us for the next chapter in our lives. Another story, high school. Thank you, Mr. Ramos. But aside from Mr. Ramos, the teacher that had homework due dates that we could all appreciate was Mr. Pennington. Mr. Pennington, we love and will forever love your Everything is Due Friday due dates. You taught us so much, sacrificing your time and making sure that we knew every formula and equation down to its core. Thank you, Mr. Pennington. Lastly, our English teacher, Mrs. White, thank you for always being so lenient with us problematic eighth graders. Your leniency and flexibility on due dates is greatly appreciated, and all of the class of 2022 loves your easygoing personality. Thank you, Mrs. White. But looking back, eighth grade wasn't all that hard. It was actually pretty fun. We had a great time during our very successful CYO soccer run, with both the boys and girls ending as semifinalists for two seasons in a row, bringing home no trophies and one broken collarbone. Sorry, Angel. Even some of the dumb things we got in trouble for are going to be fun memories that I'll never forget. You guys remember that one time Jaden mixed up PE and art and got lost at PE? Or that one time Michael wrote El Familia on his Spanish test? Even that great Christmas song made by Joshua, Jeffrey, Jaden, myself, that was streamed throughout all of eighth grade. Or even that to one time we all got up and walked out of class on April Fool's Day. I mean, look back at all the things we went through and survived. We survived online school, still surviving against TikTok, and we even survived an ongoing pandemic. As we move on to high school, I think there are many things we could all look forward to. Although many of us will be separated, a lot of us will still be together next year. It may be a goodbye to those you've known for so long, but it's also an opportunity to meet new people. And with how much our class loves to talk, I'm sure we'll have a reunion anyways. High school may be scary, but I'll offer two pieces of advice. First, stay strong in your faith. Let God's love fuel your love for others, and let him be a pillar in your life. If you believe in him, he'll guide you, and through him, you'll find your true calling. Second, stay true to yourself. Don't try to fit in, just be you. As the famous philosopher and street poet Drake once said, "I've been losing friends and finding peace, but honestly, that sounds like a fair trade to me." What this really means is, hey, it's okay to lose friends that won't help you stay true to yourself. You're never going to have to chase your lifelong buddies. They'll come and stay. Find peace in staying true to yourself, not changing yourself for others. Put up with the rain if you want to see the rainbows. Have courage. As Walt Disney once said, all of our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them. Congratulations to the class of 2022, and thank you.
Thank you, Rossi. That was wonderful. Now I'd like to call up Tina Fung, who will offer a scripture reading for us.
Please stand for a reading from the Gospel. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand, where it gives light to all in the house. Just so, your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. I would like to invite Deacon Michael back to the microphone.
It's my privilege to invite our special guest speaker, Eric Wu, to the podium, please. The 2018 Anthony Alumnus.
Hello, everyone. Before I begin, I would like to thank Deacon Cantu and Mr. Ramos for offering me the opportunity to address and inspire the graduating class of St. Anthony this year. It is an honor and a privilege to return to my alma mater, especially considering that I attended St. Anthony for only 3 years. Ladies and gentlemen of the graduating class, that's you, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Eric Wu, and I am a St. Anthony School alumnus. I recently graduated from Kennedy Catholic High School and will be attending the University of Washington next year as a freshman. I assume most of you do not remember me. After all, when I last saw you, you were all, you know, wee little fourth graders, 9-year-olds running around, running amok on the playground. But finally, after having endured 4 troublesome years since, you are all now ready to graduate. I was once in your shoes 4 years ago, anxious to graduate and poised to begin a new chapter in my life, high school. In a way, I am now wearing those same shoes as I prepare for college. Just as I will no longer be the big man on campus, you two will be the newbies in an unfamiliar setting once you all become freshmen in high school. I recall many of my peers at Kennedy who vehemently denied help from teachers and upperclassmen as they had begun their journey in high school. Because of this, many of them struggled with personal organization, and they were often late to class. As a teenager, it is easy to assume that you know everything. Spoiler alert, you don't know everything. Trust me, I've been there myself. However, there will eventually come a time when you simply will not know what to do. Do not consider yourself so high and mighty that you need not ask for help when you need it most, because you certainly will. Furthermore, bear in mind that you do not have all the answers to life. When people, especially your elders, offer you advice, even if it may be unsolicited, it is in your best interest to accept it as if they may know something that you do not. If you were to ask me whether high school will be an easy or difficult endeavor, I cannot tell you. The COVID-19 pandemic has undoubtedly done a great disservice to your class. Nevertheless, I commend your teachers' efforts, all of them, in preparing you for high school with such frustrating obstacles. Now, whether you're prepared for high school, that's entirely up to you. A motif which I had discovered through the sport of wrestling at Kennedy taught me that you do not get what you deserve unless you have rightfully earned it. In other words, you must work diligently if you intend to pursue your goals. The central theme of my school this year was be a light, a maxim that was deeply misunderstood by many of my peers. Now you may be wondering how high schoolers could misinterpret the meaning of a simple phrase. I mean, after all, we've gone through 4 years of English, so we should be able to understand what that means, right? But there's much more to being a light than what meets the eye. Being a light does not simply mean brightening a friend's day or, you know, being optimistic and hopeful, though those things are also good. But being a light requires you to recognize the darkness within yourself and others, and to recognize the monster within, commonly known as human nature. None of us are perfect. Coming to terms with your own inhibitions and shortcomings will allow you to not only become an ideal role model, but also a beacon of hope to guide those left astray in the dark. Therein lies the profound significance of being a light. If you want to be a force for change in this world, then you must develop the courage to conquer the darkness lurking within every aspect of your life, and perhaps that begins with looking in the mirror. Finally, as you graduate from St. Anthony, know that education is a lifelong journey, a cliche repeated ad nauseum, though important nonetheless. Every achievement we have made as a society is a testament to not only the will of mankind, but also to quality education. One of the greatest skills I learned at St. Anthony in the seventh grade was how to write coherently. Thank you, Mr. Ramos. I have been perfecting my writing ever since because articulation and literacy are the two most important skills that one can have. One of my biggest regrets is not having read enough throughout my high school career. Now, some of you may scoff at the thought of reading for pleasure, right? I mean, oh, reading, that's for nerds, right? Reading for pleasure. Yeah, it is. It's an activity commonly attributed to nerds and bookworms. However, reading, as well as writing, will expand not just your vocabulary, but also your ability to think critically. So why is it important to think critically? Or at all, for that matter? Well, the alternative to thinking is dying, and the former is certainly preferable to the latter. If you find yourself feeling bored while reading, then you are not doing it correctly. It is imperative that you develop an interest because your goals are derived from your interests. It is equally important to set tangible and quantifiable goals, and it's important that they're tangible and quantifiable because if you set a goal too high, then you're gonna beat yourself up for it because you might never achieve it. So it's important to set a goal, make sure it's tangible, make sure it's achievable, make sure you can quantify it. Because a wise man once said, don't compare yourself to someone else, compare yourself to who you were yesterday, not to who someone else is today. So it's prudent to set yourself some goals, for they are the tools which provide an avenue to success. If you learn to read, write, think, and speak well, then you are powerful beyond imagination. There's truly nothing more powerful than education. Education is about the most powerful tool you can possibly have. You should all be very fortunate to have this great gift, because not everybody can afford it. The pen is truly mightier than the sword. To the class of 2022, may God bless and guide you throughout your journey, both in education and in faith. Be modest, be responsible, be a light, be studious, and be willing to place your trust in God, for he can carry you farther than you can possibly fathom. Thank you.
Thank you, Eric. Now we've come to the point of our ceremony known as the Procession of Virtues, and I call up Alyssa Javier to get us started. Alyssa.
And everyone.
All of those. Emily Barbas, Lauren Cabello, and everyone else involved.
This year, we focused on a different virtue each month. These virtues were presented by each teacher to start off each new month and displayed in their classroom, with the hope of inspiring us to apply these in our daily lives. These virtues help lay the foundation for who we are and how we should treat others, not only at St. Anthony's, but in CYO, ministries to our home parishes, and in the greater community. We will carry these virtues with us as we leave St. Anthony. We have chosen the virtue that speaks to each of us individually, and tonight we bring them all together to help us remember that when we serve others and better the world, we do so with these values in mind.
We bring the gift of perseverance. With the help of God, we try to remain in the state of grace until the end of life. This year, we also studied the 7 habits of highly effective teens. The past 2 years have been challenging. This book taught us to persevere through the daily challenges of being a teenager and life in general. COVID-19 restrictions, online learning for over a year, and not seeing our friends except on a screen, learning to accept others for who they are and not who they should be, managing our time for school projects and homework, and trying to balance it all with CYO, other outside activities, and still find time for our friends and families. We persevered through all these challenges and have become a resilient class for it.
We bring the gift of prudence, the intellectual virtue whereby a human being recognizes what is good and what is evil. In our time at St. Anthony's, learning experiences like student leadership, pep club, and We Act, the school store, 7 habits, community service, and the work put in the classroom has taught us to prepare for the future. We had to use good judgment, which was sometimes a challenge, to make positive decisions for ourselves and others. This skill we will carry with us and continue to work on as we start high school. In order to make prudent decisions, we had to learn from our mistakes and failures.
We bring the gift of gratitude, the virtue by which a person acknowledges inside and out what they have received and seeks to make at least some return for their gift or favor. We are grateful for our time here at St. Anthony's, whether we've been here for 6 months, 9 years, or somewhere in between. The foundation that St. Anthony's has given us is one that we will carry with us always. We are grateful for Father Tom, Father Basil, school staff, and for all our teachers who have helped us to understand the importance of faith and education in our preparation for the future. We are grateful for neighborhood business communities around St. Anthony. We are most grateful for our parents and families who have given us the greatest gift of that, a Catholic education.
We bring the gift of hope, the confident expectation of what God has promised, its strength being faithfulness. We brought hope to others when we participated in monthly food drives, Christmas giving, and fundraisers like We Scare Hunger, the Jogathon, and Penny Wars, which helped to support our sister school in Haiti. We learned that by giving hope to others, we are able to look forward to our bright future. As we take the next step of our journey, hope will help us as we embark on new beginnings and friendships in high school.
We bring the gift of faith, a gift from God that enables us to believe in God, to accept all that He has revealed, and to respond with love for God and others. This year, we practiced our faith by starting each day in our classroom with daily prayer, sharing intentions for ourselves,
those close to us, and the world. We also attended in-person Mass with several other classes, as well with our kindergarten buddies. With our kindergarten buddies, we helped to teach them how to practice their faith. Over the years, many of us participated in Mass by being readers, altar servers, ushers, and gift bearers. This year, we studied the saints, studied scripture, and learned the history of the Catholic Church.
We bring the gift of generosity, the virtue of being unattached to material possessions, often symbolized by the giving of gifts. Throughout our 9 years at St. Anthony, we have learned to give our time, talents, and treasure. Community service hours were performed at Arise, Agape, our home parishes, and countless other organizations. Student leadership members are generous with their time planning the dance, monthly school contests and activities, Catholic Schools Week, Spirit Week, Road Owner Day, and fundraisers for the community and the world, as well as running the school store, selling hot cocoa and Italian sodas. We were generous with our time, and were humbled by those less fortunate than ourselves.
We bring the gift of courage and fortitude, the virtue of bravery in facing difficulties, especially in overcoming the fear of consequences in doing good. Many of us have shown fortitude by working through personal challenges. This was especially true when dealing with the isolation of distance learning, COVID restrictions, and readjusting to in-class learning. We showed courage this year when we embarked on the new adventure of high school visits and entrance tests. For many of us, it was our first time visiting a school without the comfort of parents and friends. Back at St. Anthony, courage served us well when giving presentations in front of our classmates and being inclusive in our friendship circles. Finally, it took courage to choose a high school that would help us reach our personal goals.
We bring the gift of charity, the gift from God that enables us to love Him and to love our neighbor. This year, we practiced the virtue of charity by bringing in donations of canned food for the food bank and the Catholic Community Service Household Goods Drive for New Homes. We also practiced the gift of charity when we participated in the Christmas Giving Program and raised money for our sister parish in Haiti with Penny Wars. In the years that we've been at St. Anthony's, we have learned the importance of giving to others.
We bring the gift of justice, the virtue by which we give to others what is due. We learn about justice when we studied civics and law in social studies, and then got to see it in action when we took a live virtual trip to the state capitol in Olympia. We applied the virtue of justice when we stood up for injustice at school during our classroom team debates and prayed for injustice happening in the world to end. We hope to continue the virtue of justice as our journey takes us to high school and we learn the importance of becoming global citizens.
We bring the gift of temperance. We practice temperance, the virtue of showing restraint and self-control assigned by reason and faith. When we took the time to disconnect from our video games and our phones, we made the conscious effort to be our friends and family and complete our homework. We also showed temperance when we had to make a day-to-day decisions about school and home. It is not always easy to practice temperance in order for us to grow academically, socially, and spiritually. We will need to always practice this virtue of self-restraint.
All right, thank you, ladies and Seamus. Now we have come to the point in the ceremony where our graduates will receive their diplomas. At this time, you are becoming St. Anthony School alumni. We are happy to welcome Wade Barbas and Haley McKinley, who will be giving you a token of your alum status. I would like to invite them forward at this time to welcome you as alums.
Hello, my name is Wade Barbas, and I am a member of the St. Anthony's Class of 1985. I'm here tonight, together with Haley McKinley, Class of 2011, to represent the St. Anthony School Alumni Association. The Alumni Association consists of the almost 6,000 students who've graduated from St. Anthony School. The almost 6,000 students who have come through St. Anthony School in the last almost 100 years. The class of 2022, you are the 94th graduating class at St. Anthony School. My daughter Emily is one of our graduates tonight. We also have two other graduates who have a parent who is a graduate of St. Anthony's School. Lily's dad, Paul, and Alyssa's dad, Jerry, are both St. Anthony graduates. Paul and Jerry, can you please stand? Thank you, guys. Many alumni have sent their children to St. Anthony School, and alumni have also returned as teachers, faculty, and staff. We have a beautiful Mary Garden in front of the school, which is dedicated to Mary Uchinsky, who was a longtime eighth grade teacher at St. Anthony's. She was also a St. Anthony graduate. And Mrs. Uchinsky, or Mrs. U, as everybody called her, also sent her five children through St. Anthony School. Her youngest, Susan, was in my class. And I think all of you know Mrs. Blodgett, who was worked at St. Anthony School for many years and has been a volunteer for the last couple years since she's retired. Mrs. Blodgett was a St. Anthony's graduate, and her husband was a St. Anthony's graduate, and they sent their kids through St. Anthony's. And Mr. Blodgett also was a teacher at St. Anthony's. Mr. and Mrs. Blodgett first met third grade at St. Anthony's School. These are just a few examples of the multi-generation families at St. Anthony's. And I know we have a few alumni here tonight. Could we please have all St. Anthony School alumni please stand? Wow, we have a lot. Wow, that's great. Thank you, alumni. Each year, St. Anthony School selects an alum to be honored with the Distinguished Alumni Award. I was blessed to be given that honor 3 years ago. This year, Haley is our Distinguished Alum Award recipient.
Thank you. I'm honored to be here with you all to celebrate this wonderful graduation celebration. I am the youngest recipient of the Distinguished Alumni Award, having graduated exactly 10 years from St. Anthony's School. And I am very excited to be here to help distribute your alumni pins. Once you receive your diploma and pins, graduates, you will no longer be students of St. Anthony School, but fellow alumni along with us. And it is a great honor.
Thank you, Haley. Okay, graduates, are you ready? On behalf of the Alumni Association, congratulations to the St. Anthony's Class of 2022, and welcome to the Alumni Association. Thank you.
Okay, so yeah, you guys will be alumni. You have to remember, when you come to the office, you have to get a guest pass. Okay, so, all right. Now I would like to invite Deacon Cantu, Father Tom, Mr. Pennington, and Mrs. White to take their places for the conferral of diplomas. I will be calling each graduate up by name to receive his or her diploma by either Father Tom or Deacon Cantu. After they have received their diploma, on their way back to their places, they will then receive their alumni pin from Mr. Barbas and Ms. McKinley. Okay, you guys know I'm gonna do my best to pronounce your names, so I've been practicing. I would now like to invite our first row of graduates to stand so we can begin the conferral of diplomas. Aubriana Lene Peralta Aquino. Jaden Arnold. Amen W. Atlabachu. Emily Gail Barbas. Jean Jime Brokenbro. Angel Buenrestro Miranda. Kenzie Lee Burgess. Olivia Christine Burgess. Nestor Flaubert Camacho the Fourth. Jasleen Juris Hurado Carrion. Seamus. Anthony Castanti. Lauren May Cavello. Desmond Trey Lizardo Davacol. Marin Renee DeRuder. Seamus Dunn. Jeffrey Edward Ng. Amy Ha. Alyssa Roselle Calonzo Javier. Lily Joy Jiping Johnson. Joshua Koontz. Aaron Lee. Eden Solomon Macoria. Sage Pagadwan Mickler. Ernesto Molina. Shay Morrissey. Paige Elizabeth Nadarski. Connor Dang Nguyen. Quang He Lam Nguyen. Bianca Okoye. Amalia Krista Sunga Pakleb. Rossi Pham. Sophia Pham Tunvan. Callista Maria Tran Maikoy Phan. Tina Fuang Ang Fung. Alexis Rose Rack. Karidu Tanu Duarte Rodriguez. Rianne Julia Rosario. Lily Christine Schultek. Soliana Seifu. Joseph George Stair. Nathaniel Sahosky. Johanna A. Tembler. Mackenzie Jane Tobin. Amy Tran. Liam T. Tran. Natasha Lay Tran. Zachary Guakian Tran. Michael Dat Trin. Sarah Ada Turkel. Michael Joseph Wiemels. Sarah Woken. Alexander Kendall Luke Wong. Brooke Michelle Xavier. Rachel Grace Zemanek. Deacon, I invite you back up here.
To conclude that section of our ceremony, it is my honor and privilege to introduce the 2022 graduating class. Turn and face your families. Here they are. We are all very proud of you. And now we've come to the graduation ceremony night awards. Graduates of St. Anthony School, tonight we have gathered parents, teachers, family, and friends to acknowledge and celebrate your hard work and the many accomplishments during your time here. Each of you have grown in ways that are unique to your own character, your own talents, and your own convictions. As Father Tom mentioned this morning during Mass, your work will go on, but we are confident that you have achieved a great foundation. Don't forget that homily, here at St. Anthony School, and are ready to take the next steps. We are certain that you are ready to embrace a more complex and challenging world. We hope you will carry with you the happy memories and come back and let us know how you're doing during the next leg in your journey. You're always welcome. Before you leave, we want to recognize a few more of you who have received remarkable honors from high schools you will be attending. And before we do that, we want to express our appreciation again for all of you who were already honored this morning at the breakfast. Will those of you who received a special award this morning please stand for a minute so we can acknowledge you once again. We honor and encourage all of you. Congratulations. And now for some additional awards. The Award for Academic Excellence. The first award is the Faculty Award for Academic Excellence, given to a student who has demonstrated a deep commitment to academic excellence and the Christian values of Catholic education. Achieving high academic standards throughout their elementary years and especially during their junior high years. This year, one student stood out from other excellent candidates for this award. The Academic Excellence Award in the amount of $750 is given to Tina Fung. And now I would like to invite our high school representatives and presenters. First of all, Eileen Denby from Holy Names Academy to present their awards, and followed by Mr. Julian Franco from Kennedy Catholic High to present their awards. But let's start with Eileen Denby. Ms. Denby, please come up.
First of all, thank you for inviting me here tonight. I'm so happy to be at St. Anthony. On behalf of Holy Names Academy, I would like to thank St. Anthony for not only inviting me, but I'd also like to extend my congratulations to all of the members of the class of 2022. I offer my gratitude to the administration, faculty, and staff for the wonderful work you've done in producing such an accomplished group of students. And parents, for all of your support, we thank you. I know these students are well prepared for high school and beyond, and I wish them all the best at their respective high schools. At this time, I would like to recognize three students who have earned special academic honors on entrance to Holy Names Academy. These distinctions are based on excellent academic record during middle school and a high score on our scholarship placement exam. At the end of the evening, I'd actually like to meet all five of our students attending Holy Names, and I have something for all of you. Earning the distinction of acceptance with honors and academy scholarships are Jasleen Carrion and Alyssa Javier. And earning the distinction of acceptance with honors is Sage Mickler. Congratulations to these students and all of the St. Anthony graduates, and please meet me in the back, all of you at the end, the five of you. Thank you.
And now would our representative from Kennedy Catholic please take their place at the podium. Mr. Franco.
Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone. My name is Julian Franco, and I serve as the Director of Admissions over at Kennedy Catholic High School. First, thank you, St. Anthony's, for the invitation and opportunity to celebrate your graduating eighth grade class. Additionally, on behalf of Kennedy Catholic, congratulations, eighth graders, on successfully completing your studies here. You did it. Regardless of if you are joining the Lancer family next year, I wish you the absolute best in your next academic chapter. I am here to celebrate and acknowledge our scholarship recipients from St. Anthony's who are joining Kennedy's class of 2026 next fall. Seven members of your graduating class, upon their admissions to our school, were also awarded scholarships. These scholars are Desmond Davicle, receiving two scholarships, Eden Makuria, Paige Nadarski, Sarah Turkel, Alex Wong, Brooke Xavier, and Rachel Zemanek. Congratulations on your academic and scholarly achievements. We are thrilled to welcome you to the Lancer family, and for all of you joining the Lancer family next year, or this upcoming fall, please come find me after graduation for a small gift from your new community. Thank you all so much.
Thank you, Mr. Franco and Ms. Denby. Okay, our next award is the Roadrunner PTC Scholarship and Discipleship Award. This is the 14th year that the Roadrunner PTC has invited graduates to apply for scholarships which are available to students attending Catholic high schools. Even though it is made more difficult to make this choice, the members of the Roadrunner PTC Steering Committee were pleased to receive outstanding entries for the two types of honors we will award tonight. The students receiving the $500 scholarship were chosen from among Catholic school-bound graduates based on their applications, in which they were asked to describe their leadership and service at St. Anthony's School and how their entire family participated in this effort to share about their hopes and dreams for high school. The selection is done without knowing the identities of the applicants. We are pleased to announce the recipients of the 2021-22 Roadrunner PTC scholarships are Paige Nadarski, and Kiradu Rodriguez. And the Discipleship Award. In addition to the scholarships, the same application process was used to identify students who will receive the Roadrunner PTC Discipleship Award. Tonight, this award will be given to a student who, in the eyes of the Roadrunner PTC Steering Committee, exemplifies the mission of St. Anthony's School, which is to, all of the graduates, to educate students to be, you need help, joyful, loving, Christ-centered people capable of, okay, you can graduate. This student will receive, have their name inscribed on a plaque which will be hung in perpetuity outside the school office and receive a St. Anthony medal. The student receiving the St. Anthony School Discipleship Award is Quang Hui Nguyen. And now we come to the St. Stephen Parent Club Scholarship and Stewardship Award. The St. Stephen the Martyr Parent Club awards $250 in scholarships to graduates attending a Catholic high school whose families have been very active in St. Stephen the Martyr Parish. Students also must have demonstrated overall excellence in academics, leadership, and community service while attending St. Anthony School. Congratulations to this year's recipients of the St. Stephen the Martyr Parent Club Scholarships. Amelia Pachleb. And Johanna Tembler. In addition, the St. Stephen the Martyr Parents Club offers a stewardship award to an applicant who, with their family, have shown service and commitment during their years at St. Anthony's School. Their name is placed on the stewardship plaque. Congratulations to this year's stewardship award recipient, Amalia Pachleb. With the end of the awards portion, we are nearing the end of our graduation ceremony. Before I call up our final speaker, I would like to express the thanks on behalf of all the parents present here tonight to all of our teachers and staff. Would all our teachers please stand up for a moment? We would like to recognize you. And particularly, we would like to thank Mr. Ramos, please stand. And Mrs. Kristen Walker White. True stars in the universe, for preparing all the special activities of this time and keeping sane. The mass, well, maybe. The mass, the retreat, the picnic, the rehearsals, the programs, and all the rest. A lot of work went into making this a special occasion for you, and you deserve it. Finally, a word of thanks to the sixth and seventh grade parents who did such a lovely job of reclaiming a tradition here at our school. This morning with the breakfast and now the reception afterwards in the hall. This is a true example of our community in action. Do unto others as you would want them to do unto you, for it is your turn next year. We are pleased and proud of every graduate this evening. For 9 years, they have held before them the mission of St. Anthony's School. Graduates, we do believe you possess skills to carry out the mission in high school and beyond. I'm impressed by your work ethic. We expect to hear about you in good ways and of your continuing growth in age, grace, and wisdom as you grow toward adulthood. Now, to close this evening's program, I would like to introduce Sage Mickler, who has been chosen by her classmates to give the final word. Sage, take the podium.
Thank you, Deacon Cantu. Good evening. My name is Sage Mickler, and I'm very honored to be speaking on behalf of the class of 2022 on their special day. Tonight, we are commemorating our years of education at St. Anthony School and formally setting us off into our new chapter of life, high school. Before I start, I'd like to congratulate all of you for your dedication and excellence throughout your years at St. Anthony School. And thank you to the parents, grandparents, and relatives who are here tonight that have supported their students' education throughout these years. Us graduates truly are the representation of how influential and impactful the Catholic education is to a child's formation. Thank you also to all the teachers and staff who have helped us academically and spiritually. We could not have done it without you. I'd also like to take a moment to appreciate Mr. Pennington and his commitment to St. Anthony for many years. He has been teaching for almost 50 years, and he is a great math teacher who goes beyond standards. Every day when he comes to class, he always carries a bright charisma that enlightens everybody's mood and spreads positivity. He also has wisdom that is rare to find. A collection of our favorite memories of Mr. Pennington was whenever he shared jokes and added commentary to our lessons. It really helped us engage while we were learning math. He is truly devoted to the success of his students and cares for every one of us. The class of 2022 wishes you well, Mr. Pennington, on your retirement, and we truly appreciate everything you've done. And now, going back in time from the beginning of our years, we have all grown in friendship and created memories that we will never forget. Strong bonds have been formed and nurtured throughout the years and have given us a memorable experience to look back on. Because of one another, we have developed into the people we are today. All of our memorable experiences are vital to who we are because it formed our identity. Even the days of heavy workloads or tests all on the same day, it still shaped our personal self. By attending school masses, helping at school events, and even working with younger students, it all contributed to our formation as human beings. From each encounter, we have gained a new life lesson that will guide us as we continue our journey. And throughout the many years, we have experienced many joys. We have gone to many fun book fairs, learned about Renton's history, and went to the museum. And we also went to BizTown in fifth grade to experience what having a job is. And one of the highlights of our years was distance learning. Even with the silence on Zoom, as we all remember, the challenge to focus with our phones, and the hybrid learning schedule that got complicated at times, we are still prepared to enter our next chapter of life. High school is going to be a change for many of us, but with all the knowledge and morals we have acquired, we should feel confident and ready to start our next phase of academics. We have learned fundamentals that we can apply to our lives, such as Mr. Ramos's essay response questions and Mrs. White's monthly writing menus. And Mr. Ramos, Mrs. White, and Mr. Pennington have worked vigorously to keep us on track for high school. Can we give a round of applause for them? You all should also be recognized for your very hard work and devotion to your studies, extracurricular activities, and the many elements of life you partake in. As a class, we have gone through many changes, but we worked through it every step of the way. And to tie this all into seven habits this year, we learned about synergy. Synergy is the interaction or cooperation of two or more people to produce a combined effect greater than the sum of their separate effects. This truly shows that we work better together rather than alone. And just a metaphorical way to interpret and understand how special our years have been at school is by picturing a cherry blossom tree. As many of us know, our school has tons of nearby cherry blossom trees that we often end up stepping on, and all the petals, we have to constantly pull them off of our shoes. But if we take a moment to think about the symbolism behind these simple but complex trees, we can find a very deep meaning. The root and trunk are a beginning. We have been given a foundation to thrive from and form new branches. The branches are similar to our journey, all over the place and uncertain. But from that uncertainty and the experiences for these many years, we have come to the end. We have bloomed off of the branches. From this end, we start a new beginning and repeat the process just like the seasons of the year. And with the gift of the Holy Spirit and God's guidance from our adolescent years, may we continue to be guided and follow in Jesus' example. St. Anthony School has taught us how to be faith-filled, loving, and respectful human beings. While keeping these morals in mind, may we go out into the world and create a difference. Let us use our talents to make an impact and positively influence others. Amanda Gorman once said, "There is always light. If only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it." I wish you all the best on your new beginning. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Father, would you please come up and give us a blessing?
I just happen to have one here handy. What a joy to be with you all tonight and to celebrate these wonderful students. They have been a joy this year here, and I know that God is going to bless them and bless those that they will continue to journey with. I'd like to invite you to stand with me now as we ask this blessing upon this graduating class. Gracious and loving God, we ask now for your almighty hand to be upon our graduates as they and their families celebrate this great milestone. May they find comfort from our community's continued embrace and support as they journey through life. May they find strength in the excellence of their academic preparation and take their place as proud alumni of St. Anthony Catholic School. Bless their lives from this day on with goodness and success. Enable them to stay true to their dreams for your greater glory, to discern what is right, good, and just, and to use their gifts wisely and in service to others. Empower them to walk into the future with faith, hope, and great love, guided by your light, that they may use their talents to, in the words of St. Ignatius Loyola, to go forth and set the world on fire. We ask this blessing in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. St. Anthony, pray for us.
Graduates, I see you're standing. So next we're going to have our processional out of the church. Can we have the music, please? Yep. You know your way. We hope to see everyone in the parish hall for a reception. Thank you very much.
take this person.